Mala. Yep.
The other big one, Smart, one of our favourites, was best on last week again for Bentley.
Yeah, I'm just trying to see, I'm just trying to find Owen Lewis Hammers, because I reckon him and Scott Laurie might have a good run at each other today, potentially. Or is it Ambrose who's starting on?
It's Ambrose gone straight to Scotty Laurie.
Don't have to have the pace, would he?
We'll see if it is. So if he's carrying an injury, he'll struggle. So we're just about all in readiness to kick off the Division 1 first semi-final this afternoon. It'll be St Paul's taking on Bentley.
It's going to be Smart up against Halliday. Beautiful little hit down to Smart. Got to Scotty Laurie. Ripped off the footy. Great tackle there from the skipper. Setting the tone early. Harley Ambrose. He'll get the free kick. Centre of the ground for the Doggies. And he'll go up towards about 30. Affengold. Muller caught at the back. Scores off heads. Quick kick out of the packs. Not a bad one. That was Dolan, I think. And he's dribbled it from about 35 metres out to the left-hand side and through for the first score of the day after 22 seconds.
Gee, the bounce of the ball there could have gone anywhere. That could just as easily trickle through for a goal in the first 30 seconds. But, is it to the left?
Weak point there for the Doggies. Backman bring the ball back into play. Going out the outer side. Smart does well. The big Backman picks it up and puts a little puck on. Handball over the top. He's got a Swindon. They've got it into the middle of the ground. Now they're bursting straight through McGarry. McGarry beats it off by hand. This is great running stuff from the Demons.
Chris Johnson it was with the booming kick inside 450. And dead set bounce on its point and came back into play. Smart tries to slap it out backwards. In the end, St Paul's do well enough and they'll rush it through for a behind. Good start.
Point eight. This tournament, not mucking around either. The Doggies, they bring straight back into play. Still over the back there for Naina, who did pretty well for the Demons. They work it towards the line through Yanofka. And the ball goes over the boundary line for throwing.
Keep an eye on Yanofka today, boys. I don't like the way he goes. He's got a good turn of speed. And I don't know that he's got the big name, so he won't have opponents looking out for him, especially.
So Halliday tries to body Smart. He gets front position. Double-handed hit down. Couldn't find a teammate. Ball's not going to come out of there, though. Well wrapped up. The umpire comes in quickly.
Really looking forward to this duel, as you said, between Bullis. Smart slaps it inside 50. Quick hands off to Laurie. Laurie can have a flying shot in towards goal. The kick was partly smothered. They're going to get another goal, and that's got holding the man. It'll be a Bentley free kick.
No, he hasn't paid it. Unless he won't get it. It's going to be out of bounds, I think.
Yep. So throw in. 40 metres out from Bentley's goal. It'll be Smart again, and as we said, Halliday is going to be work cut out this afternoon. They just wrestle each other. Laurie being important already early in this contest. Oh, spinning out of trouble beautifully for the Doggies, I think, was Matthew Brown. He kicks all the way, but Mortimer gets back. Takes a good half for Bentley.
Mortimer will switch to the other side. That's a beautiful looking kick for the Demons. Mark taken there by Meredith. Expecting to be busy today. Goes in for a pass to Naina. He feeds up a handball. This is good. Mark a play on footy from Bentley. The kick's a mongrel inside 450. Beautifully trapped there by the Doggies. They come out of defense with a very ordinary kick. Didn't hit the target. Players go in and we'll have a ball up. Umpire calling for it. No, umpire today. Normally KC has these, but Troy Wood, Joel Lewis and Riley Webster.
Good work. And you, Johnny, this time Halliday slaps it back towards the middle. They can go forward. I think that was a skipper in Ambrose. Kicks inside 50. Great use of the body there. That was fantastic stuff. And Muller tries to go back, pick it up. He might.
Oh, well done. Hold on.
It was green moving towards full forward now. And around the boundary. Is it on the floor? Or?
No, Liam Hopkins, who's just whacked it straight over the line. Playing in defence today.
Was it just tracking the mileage covered by Mitch Smarty from the big ruckman for Bentley? He's covering a lot of ground, getting plenty of first use for the footy so far with the clearances.
Well, Halliday hasn't followed him inside the 450. He's playing a kick behind the ball.
Yeah, did the same a couple of weeks ago as well.
So it's going to be Muller and Smart. Smart won it down convincingly. And they can't get the clearance though. We'll have the ball up. 20 metres out directly in front of the St Paul's goal. They're kicking to the Springvale Road end. of the ground. Smart got the hit down over the top. Spills here for Naina. Got a bit of time. Loops a handball. It's okay to O'Brien. Good vision. Saw the man out the side. That was Inovkin. Dangerous 50-50 kick, went about 12 metres, gave Massey a real task, then dropped it on the ground and did a drop kick. There's a bit happening off the ball too between Ashley Mundy and Massey, and Mundy will get the free kick.
Mundy, want to watch it there, nearly give the free kick back to Massey.
Kick after 40 metres out on about a 60 degree angle.
Massey got caught like a deer in the headlights there.
So, full to have the shot, Mundy. Now, as we said, 40 metres out, slight angle, or tight angle. He starts it at the right, and that's where it'll stay. And just links it in for one behind. That's 5 minutes gone here in the opening term. Still no goals yet. Two behinds to St Paul's, one behind to Bentley. Looks like you said...
Was it back, Tommy Backman? Anyway, the kick goes in short, finds Scotty Laurie, defensive 30. Plays on now, goes for a booming kick. Chris Johnson's got two to beat here. Oh, good strong hands. Might have been interfered in the marking contest. Not paid. Mundy can't keep it in play. And we tossed in right in front of the caravan of coverage here at Newcomen Road.
Certainly will. Right in front of your caravan of coverage here this afternoon on 88.3 Southern FM. Lovely hit out over the back. Was again by Smart for Bentley. The ball goes inside, attacking 50 for the Doggies. However, flying shot in towards goal. Again, sneaks in from behind. That's their third point. Three behinds to them. One behind to Bentley.
Certainly not demonstrating the accuracy in front of goal of the dink that the Bloods did yesterday so far.
Oh, dangerous kick in. Sorry, Wes. He put his teammate, Naina, under enormous pressure. He had to soccer it off the ground. This guy comes straight back. Here's a chance for the Doggies. Brown goes this way, that way, taken high. Dropping the ball. Advantage is paid. Comes out there to Naina again. He's been good early in this game. Gets it towards centre wing, but it's chopped down. And Timmy Walsh takes him out for the Doggies.
Walsh has it half back. Recovered from his heavy knock from last week. Ball's down at ground level. Trying to lay the tackle there. It was Aaron Hay for the Doggies. Did a good job to hold it up, and we'll have a ball up centre square. Just favouring St Paul's half of the ground. Oh, gee, there's a bit of holding in the ruck contest between Halliday and Smart. Trying to burst his way through is Kane O'Brien. Well taken down. Had plenty of stoppages already.
7 minutes gone here, Smart. Just about one every tap out so far, as you'd expect. Got it to Brown. Brown's handle was partly smothered. Going through there was Kremble. Fed it out. Now they'll go forward inside 50. They almost take him down. Eddie Kremble tries to keep it alive. Of course, his brother, earlier, Jack Kremble. Put it back to him. So we'll have a throw in. We're about 35, 40 metres out from St Paul's goal. Maybe if there's any breeze, it might be favour that end, but it's negligent.
Halliday won it down. Big fist over the back by Naina in open space. Now that's dangerous because Scotty Laurie's beautiful with his running through there. Got a little handball away from Massey. That's composed enough to turn. Great kick from the outer side of the ground. He finds Chrissy Johnson now. Oh, gee, Connor Byrne nearly gave away 50. Johnson goes in short and goes back to Massey.
So Massey is at the back of the square. Goes straight back across. The goals. They're just playing a bit of keepings off for the moment. Comes back to Massey.
Massive space for Trout. Back up forward. He's got the whole 50 to himself at the moment for Bentley.
Look, O'Brien step forward too, I reckon. Johnson takes the mark. You don't often see O'Brien trying to sneak forward, and he'll be on the end of this football. O'Brien, he's got to fly for it. We'll get to the front and centre. Ball spills down okay for Meredith. Kicks into that player, Troutbeck. He's got a one-on-one now. Now he's probably got 1-0-2. The ball's just bobbled around. He's got to use his body weight. He gets an opening goal.
That is a sign of a thrilling player, this.
It is, but it's also persistence. He was under pressure from behind. He kept working the ball in front of him. And think about our great game and the shape of our balls. If you keep running in front of you, eventually, third, fourth, or fifth bounce, it'll sit up.
And, the one,
and it did. And what a great turn of pace once he got clear.
The one thing there, he didn't lose his composure, didn't lose his feet.
I was going to say, didn't lose his feet. Most people go to ground.
Fall over.
Yeah, and it just demonstrates important for any little kids watching. About staying on your feet there, and composure is the key word right now for Bentley. They've been under pressure, but they remain composed.
Just a little quirky one. Have you ever seen a game with two number 88s playing?
I mentioned it earlier.
I think I was getting a drink at the canteen.
Actually, you were too. Yeah. So I apologise. Doggies, our player there just went to ground. The kick goes towards centre wing, right in front of the St Paul's interchange bench, and it goes over the line for a boundary throw-in. 9.5 minutes gone. 1-1-7. Bentley, three behinds for St Paul's. Looks like Huey McLean, looks like his microphone's going to lose its ice cream cone at the top there.
Ball's still in play. Quick kick out there by Ambrose. It's high up in the air. It's going to go out of bounds on the full.
Oh, of course, the other player that never got up would have been Josh Verlin.
Josh Verlin, yeah. Yep. Big loss up
there. That is a big loss.
So he's one of the two changes. Just can't figure out who
the other one is in a minute. Backman. He's got it. Backman goes right across the face. Oops, which it was too. Worked out pretty well. And finished in the hands of Mortimer. Mortimer. Yeah, it's your 1-2. They go straight into the corridor. The kick's a beauty. Oh, gee, what a put him under a bit of pressure there was Rogers. Did okay. Kicks up towards centre half forward. Ball hits the ground. Players going through. Quick ball out of there with Tom Meredith. Hacks it forward, but Halliday gets back to take a mark in defence for the Doggies.
Halliday will switch across the ground. Looking for Lewis. Good strong hands in front. I think I found that player too, Hammers, and that means Nick Halliday's going to have a very big job this afternoon in ruck.
Ah, yes, you're right.
Nick Hogan's not playing. Meredith chops it off nicely, half-back for Bentley. Oh, short kick in board from Rogers is terrible. Turned over, Knox beats a handball to McCarthy. He's 60 out. He's going to go 1-on-1 in the square. Crenball came across at the back. Got two hands to it. Couldn't bring down the mark, and the Demons have got a bit of time in the back pocket. That's not a bad kick, but Tommy back. He still took the mark. That was dangerous.
Oh, that is a tunnel.
As his commitment to that marking contest, though, just terrific. He knew it was coming, but he still went for the footy.
Tell you what, the fear he would have had, though, when you know that you can't brace your fall, he's done brilliantly. And he kicks up towards Big Walsh. Sticks out the 1-2. Couldn't finish it off. Herb Street's there. Dives on top of it. Can't get it out. Umpire will come in and ball it up.
Demon.
I will get, I'll get down to Huey now.
Just keeping an eye on Tommy Backman. He looks as though he's okay. Look, Bentley will be delighted with this so far. I reckon there's a goal breeze going towards that Frankston end.
Frankston end. We've got it in again. There we go. We said there's no Frankston end today. Oh, we missed the run sheet. Springvale Road end, they call it.
We keep going forward, a one-on-one. It's a hole. He's going to play it.
There you go.
A goal to Stevie Moore.
Well, confusion rates supreme there, boys, but one thing I'll give the umpires credit for there, they allowed the game to play on at any opportunity rather than stopping it, and that's what we want to see. No one wants to see a game that's stopped a dozen times in the space of 30 metres. So, yeah, there were a few infringements there. The advantage rule was played, and what we saw was nice open running footy.
Great stuff. 1-3-9, St Paul's. They got the lead back. Bentley 1-1-7. Leader newspaper scoreboard. We're 12 and a half minutes into this opening term. Looks like Razor Ray out there in the middle. Throws it up again. Smart does well. Knox first onto it. Oh, Knox his hands. Well, fantastic. Got it over the top there for Timmy Roberts. Goes back with the handball. Now to Gilder. Gilder for St Paul's. Brings it back into the corridor. Up they go. Flyers are up. People stay down. Bentley have got numbers on the handball. Didn't really go to anyone in particular. It's more like a big wrestling sort of thing, but it was Matty Brown, I'm pretty sure.
Kicks the goal. And I think he was very, very happy with his work.
Yes.
Challenged a few of the Bentley boys, and they tried to respond in kind.
And Owen Lewis right in the thick of things there as well, by the way. So
as I said, he's played on Dean Williamson and Ben Duthie in grand finals and driven the Nana.
Yeah, well, he started here as well. Terrific. And that poise I was talking about from Bentley, at the moment they're under pressure. They've got to start hitting targets by hand and foot if they're going to keep it short like that.
Back in the middle, free kick. Going to go to Bentley for holding the ball. And it'll be Tommy Massey. Massey, I'll tell you what, he's got a big heart. He's got a beautiful boot. He has a roaring kick. Is that going all the way to Chris Johnson?
Yeah, and he's within range here.
He is. Should go back and take the shot. Lovely kick though by Massey.
Perfectly into the space for Johnson to lead onto. So he'll kick from about 52. Gives himself a bit of a run up. It's high. It's going to land about five out from goal. Big fist at the back from the Doggies was good. Goes out to the boundary. Yanofkin cleverly kept it in play. But now the Doggies, they can. Oh, gee, they went back into the trouble there. Quick kick goes out of defence and just got a hand on it. I thought he would have tried to go down the centre of the ground there. They sort of opened it up and then, like last week, Sky went back into the trouble.
Balls inside 50s, 8-4 in favour of St Paul's, and clearances 8-4 in favour of St Paul's.
Okay. Good start for them and a couple of goals to boot. So 3-15, 1-7. Handball fed out there was okay. Knox for the Doggies. Leads it to Gilder. Gilder, now he's normally got a good boot on him. Kicks in towards half forward. A couple of players there from Bentley. So that is Hackett forward. Oh, good running through. Was by Hayes, I think it was. And his kick, as you heard, was a beauty to Timmy Roberts, 48 directly in front.
Gee, Roberts is out there. He could get going. There's no one between him and the goal scorer. He could have taken a couple of bounces and made sure of this.
Also, could have left to Krenborg. I was just going to say, Krenborg was all on his own. He could have gone to Krenborg, but he waited and he went to Muller.
That's a great lead from Muller, too. Just let him to the space. They've left that open for him. This is good open footy.
Well, it's funny because Krenborg led into the same spot only 10 seconds before that.
And then I reckon they just got out of the double way. Double lead there, just opened up the space.
See, the idea is when he leads and moves out of the way, that's where the space
and
is.
That's right,
So this guy is dead eye normally, Steve. Well, look at three behinds last week.
Yeah, he's missed a couple of curses from you this afternoon.
I think he kicked nine straight.
He did.
So 2-4, 16 St Paul's, Bentley 1-1, 7-16 gone. From the Southern FM Leader newspaper scoreboard in the opening quarter.
Well, a 9-point lead all of a sudden to the Doggies here. They probably worked harder for it. They've certainly got the ball inside their 50 more often. I'd like to see them make more use of it, though, in front of goal.
Ball comes back in. I think it is McGarry. Goes looking for Big Smart in front. Was O'Brien, was outstanding. Contested grab by O'Brien.
The umpire won't play on there.
He did, yeah. Now he's called it again. O'Brien sees the slippery north. Goes to a one-on-one on centre wing. Johnson. Wilson goes on the left foot. And it's a beauty. He's looking for Brown. Handball over the top. This is great stuff. He takes it. And puts it right through the middle. Football. That's gone from the kicking all the way.
Coast to coast. Not touched by the Doggies. And really great transition football there too. And the quality of the ball use as they run with that there. Oh, there's the handball into space at the end there.
Free kick is going to be given.
Johnson's been put down for Bentley.
And it's going to go directly in front of goals too, I think.
So that's why the ball wasn't in play, interestingly.
Like last week, the ball was inside the 50, so they'll get the free kick inside the forward 50.
So something's taken place after the goal was kicked, and it sees Johnson now getting to his feet very slowly with the ball in his hand for another shot. So we're going to have two goals, potentially, without the ball being bounced.
So, this is Johnson, 30 out directly in front. Certainly holding his face, so I didn't actually see it, boys. I wasn't looking. Anyone else did to see what it was. But to get two goals with two kicks, Johnson comes in and he's put it right in the middle. So what a turnaround. Bentley had turned a 9-point deficit into a 3-point lead in a matter of 20 seconds.
And that's a 12-point play for Bentley, and you can only assume when a man goes down there off the footy like that after a goal's been kicked, so much so he gets another shot at goal, kicks another one. It's an act of ill discipline somewhere.
Yeah.
We didn't see it. We're dubbed it. We would have got a video replay.
Go again, Bentley!
There's no doubt about it. In the end, probably the younger, probably one of the youngest of Paul's defenders, probably got sucked in there.
See how important is it?
Thanks for that, idiot!
Yeah, but you do that sort of stuff, and look what it can do to your team. Bad enough in a home away, but in a first semi-final when the season's on the line, it's just not what you want to see. Jason Heffner would be very disappointed in that.
3-1-19-2-4-16. Smart, as he's done, he's going to keep getting these hit-outs all day. Probably a great team with Shortman.
Well, yeah. I mean, who's going to ruck for St Paul's? Halliday can't ruck the whole game. I don't
think Hogan's out of the side.
They obviously wanted more run in the team. Ball comes out the side. Oh, big front on tackle there.
Hit him in the gaps, did he?
I thought they'd give a free kick.
Well, I think also with Hogan, they realised that Hogan wasn't big enough to really compete.
He's not going to be able to get someone like Smart, David Walsh. Kick goes out towards the wing. Ball off hand, scores down the hook, and Hewish lowers the ice. Nice. Oh, the big fella Walsh, he dropped an absolute pud. Butted up, did all right. Comes out to Nader, been busy. Could have got one in the back, not paid. Rogers is there. Can he pick it up cleanly? Can. He's kicked those a bit scrappy, was out, but it got to Nainer, and then Hockton Hewish again on the left foot. Not bad ball use, goes in towards the pocket. Johnson, they keep it in play. Johnson got it across there to Jace Morgan. Fortunately, ran the ball out of play.
Has he been good, Johnson, in the opening quarter?
He really strikes.
And Nainer.
Yeah. Well, Nainer's pace, I think his leg speed's the thing that really worries some Paul's defence at the moment.
It was big Smart. Now Walsh is doing the ruck work in the forward line. He might have given away a free kick. So Halliday will take the free kick for the Doggies. He pulls the trigger and goes into the corridor. Could be dangerous. As if it's turned over, it is. It'll go straight back the other way. And now here's a chance. Looks like Yanofkin. Rolls up. Yanofkin kicks into the pocket. Good kick. And guess who? Chris Johnson takes a contested grab on the left side from left footer, and he's only 25 to 30 metres out.
Yeah, we're not counting these stats, but I don't reckon he's lost a 50-50 one-on-one contest today. Yeah, so far. Yeah. He's probably won four or five. He's really doing his bit.
His handball earlier to bring more and more, and he's holding that. We were always going to say the last goal. But
they had to realise there that Yanofkin was never going to kick the goal. But they were just asleep there.
Yep. And in fairness, Johnson's probably the most dangerous. You've got to make sure him and Troutbeck are the two that are covered.
So Johnson for goal number two. Put that ball. Oh, he's stuck it through for a point, has he?
Gee, you wouldn't have thought so. Boundary umpire and the goal umpire.
That ball nearly ended up in the social club.
I think the angle was that tight. Bentley doing well. 3-2, 20, 2-4, 16, 4-point ball game. We're a minute in the time on in this opening.
There. Play on because he's taken too long and the kick sort of went off the shin in the end. They hit a target there. They're going to go in short. They're going to run the footy. Jack Frembaugh, oh, he fell over the sand again. The only man there was Walsh for it. Bentley gets it to Lawford, swings on that left foot, goes to a one-on-one trap back in front. Got hands to it, then got disposed of by St Paul's opponent. Nothing doing. The Doggies. Good composed kick out of defence and they hit Gilder at half back.
Gilder. And load up now. It'll just go down the line. It's a 2-on-1. She favours Bentley. Ball stays alive. Oh, good hack off the ground by Karamoshos. He kicks up towards Muller. He might get it back. No, Muller couldn't get it out. He does well, though. Gets a boot to ball. Backman's there for Bentley. Slung off the ball as he kicked it.
Slung the ball.
Play taken down. It'll be free kick. Was McCarthy. The umpire said play on's a call. Karamoshos feeds off a handball to nobody. If Bentley can clear, they'll get it towards centre wing. Gilder's there. And Gilder takes a good mark.
So, yeah, Gilder, he can go in centrally, but be dangerous. Goes in short to Jack Kremble. He's going to go backwards. Mark taken there by McIntyre. Now he switches the play. It's a dangerous kick. The spoil comes in, but the Doggies, they should be able to still launch it. Get out of defence now. They need a bit of run. Knox is there. He'll go through half board. Muller's there at the back. Spills out the side. They need a crumb of the Doggies. Don't quite have one. The Blinds handball was good to Hogton Hewish. And they'll get out at half back courtesy of Scotty Laurie.
They certainly well. Got Nainer in short calling for it. And he goes further down the middle. Looking for Meredith. There's too much on it for him. Doggies will bring it straight back, though. They'll get it in towards the middle of the ground. And they've got players here. But Connor Byrne is one. He couldn't get it. Turn over. Byrne does well. He picks it up. Beats off the handball. Big trouble gone. Josh McGarry. And a turnover. And the Doggies quickly go forward, Johnny.
Gilder, he trying to find Muller, overcooked the kick, Mortimer chops it off at the back, does nicely, gets it across to Walsh, sweeps it out of defence, and Sam McGarry's in plenty of space here. Oh, the umpire said, you're going off the line, I don't think St Paul's agreeing. He's on the hook down the line, I think they were smart. Too good, took the mark in front, centre wing. Oh, he's got a man all open in the 50, if it gets to him, it's massive. Sits it up in the air, getting that great mark coming across from the side.
Big fella just rushed his kick there, he saw that man trying to get it done too early, spooned it up.
Oh, another turnover though, ball comes to Naina. Naina in the middle of the game, Bentley lowers the
eyes. He's doing it all.
Johnson's lurking, he's got another one there as well. Swindon can kick around the corner. Just missing Kyle Swindon. Through for a minor score. Tell you what, the looks like Walsh. Yeah, I think they've put Walsh into the back line. Walsh has gone into the centre, so maybe it's his turn to have a go, but they great work together there, Walsh and Smart, kicking to each other.
One kick out of defence, goes straight to Bentley. Here's a chance. Naina, he's 45 out. Don't tell him he's kicking. He's going to go to a line. Oh, Bentley play hit the deck very heavily in the goal square. Doesn't pay. The dog is dangerous. Bring it out through the corridor. And more than an opportunity here, courtesy of Hay. He goes to a one-on-one. Muller in front. Takes the chest mark.
Then he's screaming forward.
Opponent cooked. He plays on now. Goes inside forward 50. Krenborg in pole position. Nearly reeled in the one-hander.
What happened to the big train whistle there? Didn't hear that at all.
Good pickup by
Fury down the boundary line.
Well, no, I was going to say good pickup by the